Welcome back, guys. So in today's lecture, I'd like us to talk about more convenient format for our tests, and we'll be using actual S expression format. And as we said, the JavaScript arrays match one-to-one already to S expressions, but we still need to use all this quotation, commas, and the actual S expression format in the string representation allows us writing the same in more clean way. So let's go ahead and introduce today the test utility with a convenient test method, which would accept our program in the string representation, right, in the S expression format. And for this, we're going to come back to parsers, and we'll implement a really tiny parser, which takes the S expression and converts to the equivalent AST format. And as we mentioned in the previous lectures, the actual parsing will be extracted into a separate class, when we'll be studying different parsing algorithms. And today I'll show you how to use the syntax tool, which is a parser generator and allows building us automatic parsers from BNF grammars. So our test method will look exactly like this. It takes the program in the S expression and we would expect the expected result. So the variable x, variable y, and let's do this expression, x times 10 plus y. Which should be equal to 120. So let's go ahead and execute. And yes, we see the test util is not implemented. Let's go ahead and edit. And the test function in our test utils should accept the EVA instance, that is the interpreter, the code in S expression, that is in string format, and the expected result. We're going to use the same strict equal assertion. And in this case, we have to parse this expression, this string of the expression to obtain the actual AST and then pass to the EVA evaluation method. And again, we're testing whether it's equal to the expected. And so, like I said, we'll be using the syntax tool. Okay, I'm going to install it from NPM, and the module is called syntax CLI. That is a command line utility for the syntax package. And the main thing we should do here is to create the actual grammar file. And so recall that BNF stands for Backus-Naur form, and this is the notation we use to define semantics, either the parsing semantics, and mainly the parsing semantics, or we've been using also the BNF to define runtime semantics. And in contrast with the runtime semantics, our parsing semantics will have only two options. This is the atom, that is the simplest expression, such as numbers and strings and symbols, and the list, that is the nested sub-expression. And then we have to define what is atom and what is list. As we said, the atom is the simplest expression and will be number, string, and symbol. And we'll get back to list a bit later after we'll define the atoms. Now, if we recall the very first lecture, we've been talking that parsing process is divided into two stages. This is the syntactic grammar, that is the actual parser, and the lexical grammar, that is the tokenizer. And in syntax, we define both grammars here. The lexical block, like the block for the lexical grammar, is defined through these delimiters, lex and closing lex. And here we're going to define the tokens. Now, first of all, we're going to skip all the white spaces. Okay, and then let's start defining our tokens. First, let's define a string. So what is a string? We said that in EVA, we'll be using double quotes notation. So a string is something in between of two double quotes, right? Plain simple. Now, the numbers are even simpler, slash d. And for symbols, that is identifiers, we'll be using special symbols, actual letters, numbers, characters like plus, times, equals, etc. Now, the syntax tool allows us doing quick tests by passing the expression we want to parse. And we also can obtain the tokens. And really, if we pass the value 42, we really see we obtain the token number with the value 42. And this is the result of our parsed value. Now let's go ahead and test strings. Oh, by the way, the quotes have to be escaped here. So wait in the slashes. And let's test it. The string hello. And yes, token type string and the value hello. Sounds great. Let's test the symbols. Okay, so the symbol foo. And yes, we got the symbol. Sounds great, we have the atoms. Now let's go down and implement the list. Again, a list will stand for a complex sub-expression. It might be an empty list or list containing some other expressions. By the way, as the result of the number token, we want to return not the string representation of the number, but convert it to the actual number. So a syntax allows doing some post-processing for tokens and special rules. And this block is called semantic action. So in the semantic action of the numbers token, we convert it to the actual number. So finally, let's go down to list. So what is list? Well, it's something start with the parentheses and followed by the list entries. The list entries is optional and followed by the closing parentheses. As the result of the list, in its semantic action, we're going to return the actual list entries. And the return value in BNF grammar is determined by this double dollar sign. In this case, we assign it to the value $2, which corresponds to the list entries, right? So open parentheses is $1, list entries is $2, and the closing parentheses is variable number 3. Since we defined a new non-terminal list entries, we have to define what it is. So the list entries is optional, right? It might be empty. And so let's put a comment that is empty. And in case it's empty, our return value for the list entry should be an empty array, right? And in case if it's not empty, it can contain multiple expressions. And the way we define it using the recursive role in the BNF, and it's written like this, list entries followed by expression. So in this case, this list entries might be substituted by anything contained in list entries, that is by itself. And so this is how we obtain the multiple expressions followed by expressions. So list entry is replaced by list entries followed by expression, again replaced by itself, etc., etc. And finally, we replace the last list entry with empty, with nothing. And so the handler for this rule should add the actual expression to the list which was created in the initial stage. And so the final result of this rule is the actual list entries collected each expression. Okay, let's go ahead and test it. Let's use a list plus 5 and foo. And as we can see here, all the tokens were parsed correctly, and we got the final value that is specifically the JavaScript array and what exactly we need. Okay, now when we have confirmed our parser works, syntax allows us generating this parser and extracting it into a separate module. For this, we pass the output option and provide the file name for the output. Let's call it Eva parser. And syntax tells us successfully generated. Let's go ahead and test it. As we can see, it's a generated parser, which is non-recursive, that is table-driven, and which means very fast parser. And now when we have a parser, let's get back to our testing code and try to execute it. And we forget passing the Eva instance to our test function. And also need to add assert module to the test utils. Okay, let's execute. And yes, all assertions passed. So now we can pass Eva expressions in the actual S expression format, and our parser will be able to convert to exactly the same underlying array structure which we use in JavaScript. Which again, as we see, one-to-one corresponds to the JS arrays, but it's even more convenient since we don't need all these quotation commas and other things. So once again, this is our BNF grammar for the parser, and it's pretty trivial, only two rules. It's either an atom or a list. And we then define what is a atom, that is number, string, and symbol, and what is list, which might be empty list or list with entries. So go ahead and play more with syntax tool. For example, you can extend support for the numbers and handle not only integer numbers as we do here, but also floating point numbers, right? And for this, you'll need to change only this rule here in the tokenizer. The regular expression for the numbers token will slightly be different. Okay, so that's it for today. And in the next lecture, we'll start talking about functions and we'll consider the first type, built-in or the native functions. Thanks and see you in the class.